In this module, we're going to talk about RBAC and specifically some strategies around how to best handle it, how to manage it, and how to best consume it and use it in your applications. Ted, could you tell us a little bit about RBAC?
Sure. So RBAC, or it's role-based access control. And when we're talking about RBAC within Azure, there's in the new portal, you can create users and groups, and then you can add users to those groups or those roles that you create. And then that way you can make sure that your users have only the access to the resources that they need access to in order to perform their job function. So if you think about it, you could have different users here. So if we go here, and we have a few different users. I'll just use stick figures for these users. And then you have your application here, and you might have a database over here, and then database down here, but only one user needs access to one database. You could use this user, and you could basically provide him access to a resource group or to that database, or a resource group that owns this database. So this user can have access to this database, and this user can have access to this database, but they don't have access to the other databases that they don't need access to perform the job functions. So if we take a look at this, and we switch over to the Azure portal, and we want to take a look at this, how you would assign these users and these roles is you would go down to your subscriptions, click on your subscription, and then you see this little icon here that has these two people here. And you see that your user, which my user is a subscription admin, it's an inherited role. And then you see these roles here. And there are many different roles. You have owner, contributor, or reader. And these three are key roles for the entire subscription. So if you want to add somebody to the owner role, they would have access to create and delete and take care of everything that anybody as a subscription admin would have. Then you have the contributor role, which provides a read-write access to these different groups. And then you have the reader role, which is only read access to the different resources. And then you have all these different roles here that relate back to some of your different resources. So if you have a data factory that you want to add just one resource to, but they don't need access to any of the other resources in your Azure subscription, you can use this data factory contributor role and add that user here. And the way you do that is just click add, and then you would input their email address. And this can be usually it's tied into Azure Active Directory, or you could also use a MSA account to add the user there. And there are also what's called you can create different roles. So if some of the roles here don't match what you're trying to do or match the level of access that you're trying to grant, you can create different roles that will take care. You can add different resources to those different created roles, so you can add the exact level of access that you want to give out to these different users. And these roles here, when we're dealing with RBAC in the new portal, are a little bit different than than how we used to grant access in the old portal, which would be to add users as a co-administrator to the subscription. So you'd go down to your settings and add as co-administrator, and that would be kind of like very similar to adding as an owner here, but you didn't really have, you couldn't really specify access to the different resources within Azure and within your subscription. So you added them as a contributor and they could do anything inside the subscription. Whereas here you can specify down to the resource or the resource group and add the users there.
Yeah, I think it's a good point that this is a lot more granular. So when you start thinking about RBAC specifically, just like Ed said, it's very much about how can we restrict access down to exactly what we need profiles to do, whether they're a service principal, like an actual application that's acting on our behalf, or an actual user. I wanted to touch on one thing. I'll show you my portal screen here. Ed had mentioned you could do custom roles. And if you see on my screen right now, Ed just showed you there was a bunch of roles that are defined out here. So if you looked at someone like a contributor here, you can click on this button right here that says permissions. And if you click on that, you can actually see what permissions are included with this, which is a lot for that one, right? Because that's at the subscription level. But I have one in here that's actually a good use case. So right here, this audit log reader. And if you hover over it, you can see it says reads all the audit logs. So in this case, I needed to create a profile for an application that only could read audit logs from Azure. That's all it could do. If it comes into the portal, it can't create anything. It can't do anything. It can only monitor these. And so when you go under the permissions, you can see that I've added just the things that it needs for Insights API that it's going to call. So that's done through PowerShell. There's no way to do that through the portal right now. So if you want to do those custom rules, you basically have to use PowerShell to export an existing role, and then you'll whittle that role down. So basically, you export it as JSON, and then you modify that JSON to include only the things you want, and then you give it a unique name and put it up in the portal.
Yeah. So I think that covers a lot about RBAC and how resource management is compared in the new portal versus the old portal, where we had co-administrators for the subscription.